Hello and welcome. This motherboard caught my attention due to two aspects. One, it is LGA 1700 socket, meaning you supply your own CPU. That adds to overall costs, but you are no longer bound by N5095 or N100 CPUs you normally find for this sort of motherboards. Two, it has 8 SATA ports. Normally you find 6 SATA ports with an embedded CPU. Although I don't need this feature, it has 3 M.2 slots, which is extremely rare for ITX motherboards. It also has a PCIe 16X slot. However, it's unlikely that it's 16 lanes due to the 3 M.2 slots. It's very likely 8 lanes. But I am not going to test that since this is going straight into my 2U NAS. Finally, you see a USB 2 port on the motherboard. It may seem weird, but this is not surprising since this is meant for a server. In my case, I'd put my Unraid USB stick into that port. USB 2 is specifically favored for this sort of operation, since USB 3 port tends to make USB drives work harder and therefore wear down faster. I am going to install i312100 with just a single stick of 16GB DDR5 RAM. Yes, this motherboard supports DDR5. I would have preferred DDR4, but this is just a minor complaint. As I said earlier, this is going straight into my 2U Unraid NAS. Before that though, I will see whether it boots and show you the BIOS screen. Here we are, all assembled. I've also installed 3 M.2 drives, but these are SATA drives. I don't believe these will be detected. We will see. These M.2 slots are very likely NVME. You may have also noticed that I used a thermal paper instead of paste. I use thermal papers for low power builds. They are reusable and cleaner. More importantly, they are only slightly worse than thermal paste. Good news is that it booted. And the BIOS looks to be quite comprehensive, although how much of it is actually functional is questionable. More importantly, the BIOS date is quite recent, although it's not recent enough to safely use Intel's 13th and 14th generation CPUs on this. Only Alder Lake CPUs are recommended for this. As expected, the 3 M.2 SATA drives are not detected. I will install NVME drives to see whether they are detected later. Anyway, for those who want to see the BIOS screen, I am not going to speed this up. If you wish to skip this, fast forward to 7 minutes and 30 seconds. NVMe drives are detected properly. It's showing only two, because I have only two spare drives. These are very likely version 3 ports. Anyway, there is something I forgot to mention. This motherboard is probably rated for only 65 watts CPU, and below due to the number of MOSFETs I am seeing on it. Keep that in mind. You don't use power-hungry CPUs for these kind of builds anyway. Okay, it's time to get the motherboard out of my Unraid NAS. You may recall this if you've watched my 2U NAS video before. I just need to swap out the motherboard. Everything else will remain the same. The beauty of Unraid is with its simplicity. It doesn't care what CPU and motherboard you use. All it remembers is the hard drive serial numbers. Meaning, even though I swapped out CPU, motherboard, and RAM, it won't care and will boot as usual. As long as it detects the original hard drives, all will be fine. Yep, everything is good, drives are detected, and there is no error. So, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Oh, and I forgot to mention another thing. It does have two Intel 2.5 gigabit Ethernet network interfaces, so the motherboard is very useful in more ways than one. 8 SATA ports, 3 NVMe slots, a physical PCIe 16 slot, and 2 Ethernet ports. All for just $90. Can't beat that.